I want you to listen to this because it's something that you can tell me how you would have handled it. I was reading a piece on Yakupov, the kid from Edmonton, and his draft year. And on the morning of the draft, Steve Tambellini, who's a good guy, Steve sends a note to all his scouts. He wants them to re-vote on who they want to pick number one. And the vote came back 9-2 against Yakupov. The Oilers picked Yakupov, and Tambellini would not make the announcement. What happened?
Wow.
Yeah, it's in the sportsnet.ca. I was fascinated by it, and I still don't have the answer. It was either Kevin Lowe, Craig McTavish, or the owner who overruled Tambellini.
But Tambellini, wasn't he the general manager at the time?
Yeah.
And they went a vote
9-2 against, and they picked the guy who with the two votes.
Holy fuck.
Yeah. Unbelievable.
How would they do that?
And nobody has confessed as to what happened. And Tambellini won't say anything, nor will the other three. But I've never heard of that before. That's reason for resignation.
Oh, yeah. I never heard of anything like that before, ever. Because the general manager really has the final say.
Yeah. Yep. And,
well, okay, if the general manager has the final say, how did this scenario play out, and how did this scenario come to fruition?
Well, first of all, Yakupov was the wrong pick, Frank, whether retrospectively or just he was not the type of player that the Rangers needed, or that the Oilers needed. They wanted, the scouts wanted to take that Murray kid from
Columbus. Harry Murray, I think. No.
He plays in Columbus now.
Right? Yeah.
Murray? What's his name?
I think it's Ryan Murray.
I think it's Ryan, too. I was going to say Ryan. Anyway, it's the kid. He's a good defenseman. And that was a bad year for the draft. Let's face that. And so the votes that they had in the 9-2 were for Galchenyuk, who's with Montreal and played with Yakupov and Sarnia, and Murray. Those were the three guys that were the number one selections by the scouts. Only two picked Yakupov. And Yakupov ended up being their choice. And for the life of me, I don't know, it wouldn't be the owner. It had to be the influence of Lowe or McTavish. And yet,
yeah, who was chief scout then, do you remember?
McDonald, Stu McDonald.
Is he still there?
No. But he was a good scout, Phil, according to the information that I got.
Yeah, but again, guys, I come full circle. Wouldn't the GM have the final say? That's what a GM's task is. Maybe I'm fucking stupid.
No, but Frank, you see, Steve was not a leading candidate for a general manager job. I say that very respectfully because he's a great kid, great man, very well organized, and Kevin Lowe was his
strong hockey player.
Kevin Lowe obviously said, look, Steve, I want you to manage the team, but McTavish, the owner, and I are going to have the final say. That's the only way I can see the way it worked. So Steve comes and he said, we're ready to pick Ryan Murray. And what was the vote? It was 9-2 against Yakupov. Well, we'll give you the name this afternoon. Now, I don't know what you can say. If you were hired as a general manager and you had some pull when you were hired, you have reason to resign. If you weren't and you were told what was going to happen, in other words, three guys are going to run the hockey operation and we don't want it to be a public issue, that's the only explanation I can give for that kind of a thing happening.
Huh.
Well, I would say that's a good rationale.
Yeah.
I never heard of it.
And I don't think it would be the owner. He ran Rexall, you know, Cates. It would be McTavish or Lowe.
Mr. Cates is very synonymous with hiring people and letting them do their job. I know Daryl very well on a personal level. He's a very smart man. And if he hires you to do a job, you do the job. He's not a meddler. The only time he meddles is if he doesn't have the results and you're fired and he gets another guy.
Frank, they missed the playoffs 11 straight years. 11.
That's right.
And you wonder why the Canadian, it has nothing to do with the players born in Canada. It has to do with the ownership and management in the NHL in Canada. Montreal, they were the team that interfered on an ownership level to sign Subban when Bergevin and Subban's agent were at $5 million. That's what he's worth. They paid $9 million for him. Then you go to Toronto, you don't have to talk about that. You go to Winnipeg and you know that the owner, who's a great guy, but spends too much time in the dressing room. I needn't say any more about that. You go to Ottawa, and Eugene the Dancing Machine is a wreck. He's a wreck. I hope his health is good, but he's a wreck. And then you move into Edmonton. We just told that story. Calgary, well, it's Berkey and the boys, and they're not doing too badly. Vancouver, ownership is interfering all the time. They don't want to rebuild. They want to patch and fill.